Ross trip of the day. Let's head into the Greenville home base, Ross, and let's see what they got.
Let's find out. Are we in time for the restock? Or are we too early? All right, what do we got up here? It's Chewbacca. I got some Minecraft stuff. I don't know if I've seen Minecraft up here before or not. I'm sure I probably have, but some Hot Wheels. I got Ahsoka laying back there. Got some more Ahsoka. There's a bunch of Star Wars stuff. I can't tell what it is, though. They're all going to be Ahsokas that are... I need to clean this up a little bit. Yep, they're all Ahsokas. So, we've seen the Ahsoka 3¾ figure a bunch of times. No sense in digging it out there, is there? Got some McFarlane anime stuff back in there. Super Mario. Roblox Power Rangers swords. Oh, here we go. Here's a couple of Sentinels. So they had stocked. I was in here yesterday. They didn't have these Sentinels out, so pretty sweet. We got Blue Marvel. I've had those for a little bit, so the same old, same old. What do we got down here? Bunch of Psycho Man. Star Wars back in, like a big stock of it. Jen Erso, Ahsoka, Lando, and Lando. There's that Princess Leia. What transform we got behind here? Don't happen to have any more of the X-Men cottage figures, do they? Don't see them. Still got a buttload of Static Shock. And Madam Hydra looking at me. So I can put a few Sentinels out and some stuff this morning, so that's pretty cool to see. We may have already missed the card at X-Men if I had those with them. That's okay, we got to pick them up here a while back, but still be cool to see them again. Alright everybody, that's gonna do it for this part. We're gonna head over to the tables and see what they got there. If I find anything, I'll show it to you. If I don't, I'll see you the next one. Well, over here on the tables, they definitely had a restock. Man, look at this. It's those Croc Masters I have seen at a Ross. So we got Croc Masters, and we've got some Sentinels this morning. Let's see what else we can find here. They got a buttload more. They finally got both the twins here. I can't get a hold of it to make sure it's what it is. Yeah. Got the two twins in there, so good GIJoe restock here. I've not seen any for a while. They got these Power Rangers sets. We saw those at the Johnson City Ross over the weekend. One good thing, it's all kind of organized. It's easy to look through right now. Let's see. There's some Halo figs. I haven't seen these here before. Smaller scale, Halo Infinite. Statues. Got another $3.99 Mando figure. Oh, they got that big Halo walking. I'm gonna take a picture of that. The Mantis. How much is the Mantis thing? $9.99 for that. That's pretty cool. It was like an Ed 209 vibe from RoboCop. More Mandalorian, and we shall return.
Bristol, Virginia, Ross. One of my ones I'm in the most. Let's run in here, see if they got anything for me today.
Here we go, Bristol, Ross. This place just like the one in Greenville. Crocmaster has shown back up with a vengeance. That's something new, too. Flying Petrosaur, but I don't know how to say that. Then you got the Rajasaurus, Triceratops. We saw these Halo figures in Greenville as well. Yeah, some different stuff here up at the front, but a bunch of GIJoes. So let's head back now, see what we can find. Excellent. Got a little bit of a restock on Joes here as well. There's some more Zaymont. Is that Transformers, Micro Machines, Fifth Brother, Hey, I'll go ahead and leave one there.
Yeah.
These anime things. Not seeing any of the X-Men stuff. They may have beat us. There are Siren. I guess that's kind of classified as X-Men. Another Siren. All these usual Transformers. Alright, not seeing anything sexy inside on the bottom. Let's see if we can find anything back in the regular figures. Well, so they had the Toddy Mac dump here, but it's all been anime. None of the Mortal Kombat figures I'm seeing. We got any legends or anything back here? This little bear back here, I'm going honest with you. Already peeked at the back side. There's people back there. There's nothing back there either. Yeah, it looks like there's not a long, whole lot here right now, guys. We may have missed the big restock, but that's okay. We'll be checking back in here several times this week. Let's go over here and check the tables now. See if we see anything.
He's three.
Yeah. There's the... There are some people there. Dungeons and Dragons. A wave of those. And Pokemon Select. What is that? Madison knows what that is. They got some more there. I don't know if they got any different ones or not. Up there, got these Power Rangers, Coco Melon stuff, one of the Batwheels. I don't see anything behind this, but let's see. There's the Micro Machines, big little city thing there. That's different looking. Like a little car city, that's kind of cool.
Mom, he'll
play with it for how much is that thing? $23. And then I'll take deck ramps. And unfortunately, everybody, that looks like that's going to be all. Oh, Kelly found a Vulcan. They do have a legend. But we'll hit this place again later this week once we can find some more stuff. But if we see anything else here, we'll show it to you. If not, see you at the next one. All right, beautiful ice cold winter day. Let's go into Ross, see if they got some hot bills for us. All right, we're here at Ross, and look at this, more NECA. You got Reagan from The Exorcist, and these are $11.99. You've got Alf, Gordon Shumway. You got Vampire. This is a Target right now, I'm pretty sure. And then you've got the Hocus Pocus figures here. You got Billy Butcherson and Winifred Sanderson. So, and we've got some Trey Young starting lineup. Hopefully got some X-Men in here. Got some Attack on, Dead and Seven Deadly Sins, King figure. There's some Nova up there, 3 3/4. One of them unpunched. Transformers, what is this? Optimus Prime, package free. Plastic free packaging. Where's the price tag on him? Oh, there it is, $5.99. And they got another one here, Starscream. And Shockwave, and then Bumblebee. See, that's pretty cool. Autobots Unite, Star Wars, Fifth Brother. There's a Gore Siren, a couple more Sirens, and another Siren, and Gore. Oh, beyond the bottom down, there's Maximum Venom, big sets. Oh, they got one of the Power Rangers. Pig Guys in Lunchbox for $8.99. That is pretty sweet as well. And then, don't see anything else down there. Yeah, some good stuff so far. Let's get back to the toy section and see what they got. We didn't even look at the bottom of the shelf down there. We see those little yellow boxes there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of them. They got this thing, the little pig guy. This was an exclusive to somewhere. $8.99 here at Ross. So, yeah, they got those things. We got to get back to the toy section. But the stuff they've got up here, there's got to be some good stuff back there. So, let's go. All right, here we go, toy section. Some Power Rangers swords. There is more. NECA. Elvira. I'm pretty sure that one is new right now. Still in stores. And then we've got Svengoolie. That is pretty cool right there. Like a because it's the NECA that's still kind of new in stores out here. Let's talk about it on this back end. I kind of glanced at the toys when I came by. Didn't see any carter figs. Can't get there now, but let's go see what's on the tables. All right, here we are in the toys table. And look right here, number 55, G.I. Joe Classified. Recondos, $5.99. I heard these were hitting as well. Also heard rumors of new Copperheads already hitting, but don't see that. Oh, lady's got a, here's another one of those pig guys. Man, this thing's bulky. I just saw another stock cart coming out. We're gonna hang around and see what's on. Some micro machines. Still got three of the Dungeons and Dragons here. I don't know who the characters are, but you can look over there. I think the one guy I always saw at GameStop is gone. Whatever his name was. It was a big Fortnite thing. What is this? That big rig looking thing. I can't hardly get it out. Oh, you got a little 18 Miller thing there. That's pretty cool. And then all of this wonderful stuff. Oh, there's a stock cart. We're going to check that out. I see some other one of these Fortnite trucks on it. Want to see what else they got. Oh, they got the Power Ranger thing there too. I don't know if I saw that here yesterday or not. What is on this side? Sorry for the sniffling, guys. It's cold outside and warm in here. There's those little Pokemon things. We saw those yesterday when the Spoofs and I were out. All those Copperheads I saw here last time, not Copperheads, but the Crocmasters, are gone. They've actually got rid of a lot of their tables up front. It's kind of sad making, seeing them start to take some stuff down. And on this one, this doesn't look like anything we're looking for. There's some Halo Mega Blocks. Oh, we've already seen that before. All right, let's go see if that lady will let me look at her stock cart, or if I can sneak by and look at it and see what's on it. But yeah, finding some new stuff this morning. We got the Power Rangers pig, and we got Recondo. And we'll get to the toy section there in a second. Alrighty, here's our end cap. Some more micro machines back in there. Nothing too sexy and exciting up here. Got those My Hero figures. Anything over here on the girly side? Let's see if anybody stuck anything over there. Let's see what we got here. The Power Ranger thing, some Minecraft, Bleach statues. I don't know anything about the anime stuff, guys. I apologize. Don't see anything here. Not much down through here either. More of those statues. And then Mario. And yesterday they did have some Sentinels, so I'm not seeing those. They were right here or here. One, I didn't think those would last though. That X-Men stuff does not sit on the shelf here long when it hits. Yeah, I don't really got anything too sexy and exciting over here. Monkey Kid. All right, I think that's all we got. Let's go see what else they're putting out for stock. One more thing, guys, you see it back there. Look here, check your Ross store. They are getting shipwrecked, so that's pretty cool. And still nothing else they put out here. Only a different thing since I've been standing around. They have this guy, Admiral Ackbar, Return of the Jedi. That's pretty cool. So check on Ross. Let's see what we got. I got the sale prices going on here. I don't see anything different or exciting in Transformers. Still got that Stranger Things collab going on. The Hideous Superman 2 Punk. Got the Titan figure. Man, those are marked down to $4.99, the 12-inch Beetle figures. I only see one of them there. Carapax. And that's all the Blue Beetles I got left. $3.99 up there for the small spin match. Oh, look here. This thing fall. That's like the, I don't think it's like the sixth or seventh time I have found a platinum Gordon as Batman. What else they got here is Hush. A couple of Hush. A regular Jim Gordon as Batman. Dark Knights of Steel. Oh, they got that one right there. Sweet. The Two Faces Batman. That one's nice. Another Batwing. Build-A-Figs, Wonder Woman, $9.99 for this gold label Aquaman. That's tempting. I don't need it, but it's tempting just because it's $9.99. I wonder if all of these are $9.99. $12.49 for GIJoe. Copperhead there is not on sale. The regular copperhead is starting to hit Ross stores. Triple bubbles, anti-monitor. They got Justice Busters. Nope, just anti-monitors. There's the X-Men 5-pack. I'm still going back and forth about buying. Hopefully I can catch it on clearance. All this stuff's finally cleared out. I still got some of the Legends, actually. Looks like Agatha and Warrior Gamora is about it. There's an MJ. No one seems to want poor MJ. Although, yep, all MJs. Man, Scarlet Witch down to $12.50. I might have got her for that. Magneto's the only one at $7.49 here. Agatha's $7.49. Nobody still wants it. $12.49. I ordered all these offline, just a spoiler alert, that whole wave. Kingpin was down, I thought he was $9. That's, yeah, $12.49. I thought he was down to $9.99. The Venom Space Knight set, they got restock on those. And don't see anything in the action figure aisle, and I can't film there or the next aisle, so we'll be right back. Got Beth Phoenix hanging out there. This been picked clean with the sale prices. $9.99 for Samoa Joe. Well, he's only $10 as well. That's pretty cool. And they got a few of them here. I picked one of those up for the giveaway. I actually ended up returning it. 1,000 sub giveaway. Master of the Universe. Yep, cloth. I can't look at that. That's unbelievable. Of course, all those are gone. Talon Fighter down there. One of those left for $16. Of course, the only thing still left are the ones that are expensive. I might have gotten a Ram Man for $9.80. They had him on the app. I started to order him, but it's one that I found in the store. To me, that's a sign. Yes, Chris, you need to buy it. If I don't see it in the store, that's just the way the universe's way of trying to save me some money. Ooh, excuse me. This is all mostly pit clean, guys. And a lot of stuff here. But let's go check some diecast and let's see what they got over there. Dinosaurs. Well, looking at collectors here, looks like it's a little picked over. I don't think they had a restock here. Hey, here's Sean Connery. I do have a Steel Clan robot. That's one of the coolest looking of the Gargoyles Nexus, I think. Check out that robot. He is massive. That thing is awesome. Still got some of the back cuffs here, the walkie talkies, and then the transmitter replicas. Michael Myers. I haven't seen him yet at Ross. One of my viewers, though, told me they found the Michael Myers. Giuliana. Got the 17 Romero dude. Still got some Pee Wee Hermans. Two of him left. Batgirl. Some Gotham Knights. Yeah. Ray Filet. Triple H and Ronda. Man, they have cleared this stuff out. I wonder if that was on sale. That was pretty thickly stocked last time. Electro Daredevils, Funko minifigures. This is down to $7.50. I don't think that would include these. Pop Vintage cover, Scarlet Witch collectible, Target exclusive. They don't have Wolverine on sale, do they? Wolverine's down to $20.99, down $9. Do they have one? Yeah, they got some back there. Ah, that was tempting because I would get 5% off of that. What else we got here? Is that Batman? I hear a stop code. It's empty. Animated series Bat Cycle. Oh, I got a Magneto now. Have I seen him? That's kind of cool. Is it on sale? I don't think it's on sale. Thor. Nah, it may not be. It may be. I don't know if it is. $20.99. That's pretty cool, though. I got the pixelated Magneto as well. This has got Captain America in that version. This is the only Target I've actually seen that Captain America pop in. I don't see it. I don't like digging through the pops. Wolverine's tempting, but I don't think I want to get that. I'm trying to get out of buying pops. Aretha Franklin. Prince John. Oh, we still got a good stock of these. Oh, the foot soldier looks pretty cool. Guess I'm not paying $20.49 for that. That's ridiculous. I wonder if they're still on sale for $9.99, the same as those are. Still don't want them. Well, they got the Toka and Rosshaul now. I'd only seen these at, I get a good angle on that. I can't get a good angle to get them down, get a picture. I'd only seen those at GameStop so far. Now look here, another platinum. We got him and Jim Gordon here. There's Batman, Scarecrow, Batman, Scarecrow, Batman, Batman. It's no Robin, no Mr. Freeze. Don't see anything else back here. We're going to check this little side section. Where's Superman? This little side section over here and see what they got. If I find anything else, I'll let you see it. If I don't, we'll probably see you at the next one. Hawkman. One thing I did want to show, they had 10 of these things last week. They're down now to just one remaining because it is on sale. 50 down 20 bucks, $79.99 to $59.99. So
hello.
If you're looking for Snake Mountain, check your Target. They are on sale now, 20 bucks off. They may hang around to clearance, who knows? But again, if you're looking for one, check Target. We've had a little bit of a funky work schedule this week, so I'm actually getting to the Walmart here in Bristol a little bit later than usual. But let's go in here, see if they got anything left. Alrighty, good old Bristol Walmart. A bunch of Eddie Kingston's up there, some WWE, but I'm not gonna dig back through all that. I got some superstars shaking in their boots. Macho Man, The Rock, Rick Rude, and Earthquake. That's pretty cool. There's some more. No Blue Boots open, is there? Nope. Earthquake and Rocks. I just saw him at Ross for $5.99. And they got a bunch of stuff just laying around down here. Still got, or I think they had Ortiz last week when I was here. But I don't see any more new AEW outside of those Walmart exclusives. Oh, here's Punk again. They got three Punks. What have we got over here? One Moss Man. Don't see anything up top hiding out anywhere. Like a snake, old superpowers on clearance here. There's Hush Batman again. Dark Knights of Steel, Black Lightning, a Batwing. Dark Knights of Steel, Black Lightning, and Black Lightning. Batmobile, they got some lantern vampires. Those are all Black Lightning. Somebody else has already looked through this, obviously, to see what was back in there. Here's a Robin. Oh. Batmobiles, invisible jets. What else we got? Something's on clearance for $6. Surprise eggs. I guess these things? Or these things? I don't know. X-Men 97 and more X-Men 97. Magneto, Wolverine, Rogue, Storm, Gambit. They got the whole wave again. Sitting there, it's pretty cool. These are cheap on Target.com to look up right now. A lot of them are on sale in the store as well. I just learned a second ago, there's Matt Murdock and MJ Steel. And I'm sure everybody already knew this, but I didn't know they would price match the app. That's cool. You'll see in the pickup there, the haul portion of this video, I found Kingpin was $12.49 on the shelf, and then I took him up to the register and they price matched it down to $9.99 what the app had. Dinos. I'm not seeing a whole lot sexy and exciting this morning. Or it's probably afternoon by now. I keep used to being here in the morning time. Don't see any Snarls. What they got up here? There's Ratchet. So now they got a rat. There's two Ratchets. And they got Cybertron. Oh, they got a bunch of Ratchets. Ratchet, Ratchet, Ratchet. And then Junkie. So they got five Ratchets here. That's pretty cool. Must have seen him at one place. Pokemon cards and tins. We'll just scan the video game stuff here. Some people down to lower end. So we already looked at the wrestlers and the GIJoes anyway. All right, that's all I'm seeing, guys. Let's head over and check out some diecast, and then we'll see what they got in collectors. Ross Dress for Less, here in beautiful Johnson City, Tennessee. Let's run in here and see what we can find. We timed Bristol just right with the restock. We're here a little bit later at this one, so let's see what they got. All right, guys, you can see we've already got some NECA here. Ash, Voorhees, Pennywise, the Rocker Superman, the Darkfather Build-A-Figure series. Our first time seeing a Universal Monster here. Kind of glad they don't have any Dracula, I'll probably buy it, but My Bloody Valentine, the Miner. We're going to hang on to a couple of these. I don't know about, I've already got Jason. He's what, $11.99? He doesn't have a price sticker on him. We might get Jason. I've already got this, but I like to have one to open. And then I'm gonna hold on to this Dark Father Build-A-Figure. Let's see what else we can find. Tom Brady Hammond collection. What is that? Back in here is the Concavenator. And there's an anime statue. More anime. What have we got down here? Star Wars stuff. Or is that Power Rangers set? They still got one of those at least. I haven't seen any more. I got Red Series here. Those seem to be getting a restock. There's a Megatron. Rival, Sonic. And what's down here? Not a whole lot down here. Marge, My Hero Academia. Not seeing any Marvel Legends yet. I mean, they gotta have at least a Siren somewhere, right? Another dinosaur in there. I don't know which one that is. Let's put these guys down for a second. I should have got a buggy. That's what I need to start doing when I come in these stores, is get me a buggy. That's the Rajazarosaurus. I got a couple of cat women. Seven Deadly Sin stuff. That character King. I've been seeing him quite a bit. And there's another one with Power Ranger sets and those 18 wheelers from Fortnite. We can actually get a better look at it here. Well, I think we can. Man, that's remote control. That's awesome. That's that Bro Thor. $25 for that. Man, that's... I didn't know it was remote control. Sorry, guys. I kind of lingered on that there. That's tempting for $25. Let's see what's behind this stuff here. Jason figures not want to stand up. I don't see anything. I'm going to try to do this without making a mess. There's a Goomba, a flying Goomba from Mario under there. It's the only thing that I really see. What's behind these army sets? Beyblade. Let's try to get back in here a little better. What's in that case there? Oh, it's an ear makeup or something. So I just put back there. If we were getting Christmas presents for Christmas. What else? Let's see. A bunch of diecast here stacked up. There's some Gundam. I don't think that's what Cosmos is in. Oh, no, that's a tiger guy. Another one with Power Rangers sets. My Hero Academia. Gundam, I think I already said that. Oh, there's another one of those Power Rangers things. I got a pretty good amount of those, actually. This thing is cool. I saw this. How much is this thing? This is tempting. I think it would look really cool. Sitting on a shelf. Then again, do I really need it? How much is it? Oh, $10. Not bad. And there's the Chaos Double Agent. Been a while since I've seen him here. Sonic back in there. Yeah, I'm surprised I have not seen a Siren. What's up here? Statues. Another Power Rangers set. I thought I saw a remnant of a Transformer somewhere. Oh, where's one back there? It's that little kitty Grimlock thingy. What's down here on the pegs? Transformers, Micro Machine. There's there we go. Marvel Legends. There's Darwin. Kamek, little tiny one. Another Concavenator. All right, let's get over to the racks or tables in the middle and see what we got. If we do see anything, we'll show it to you. If not, then I'll see you at the next one. All right, yeah, Sam. There's some more NECA. Man, NECA's really hitting that now, so check your Ross store. There's also some Platinums of that guy. No Platinum. Haven't seen the Mortal Kombat figures either, but anyways, let's get over and check the other shelves. Alrighty, we got some more stuff over here, but look at this. I have not seen this either. I guess let's put my figures down there. More McFarlane dump, $4.99 Witcher figures. There's Geralt, Siri, whoop, and another Geralt. That was cool. My fat roll knocked it right down on the shelf. I was supposed to be on it. Good save by the old belly. Oh, what else we got back here? Spider-Man. No X-Men hiding over in there. Marvel Legends, if they were any here, must have already gotten wiped out. There's baby Grogu back there, baby Yoda. Haven't seen him in a while. Somebody's got a Lego set stuck back here. What is this? Power Rangers Void Knight Gear Up Pack. Kind of cool. Oh. The Witcher figures are cool. Those are a little bit tempting, I'm not gonna lie. At least Geralt. And let's put these guys right here. Hang out there for a minute, boys. What do we got here out front? Oh, yes, here we go. $5.99, guys. Oh, I looked at that guy and lusted over him at GameStop when he was on clearance for a higher price than that. All right, we're going to have to turn this off and make some decisions on what we're going to possibly purchase. But we will have some pickups from this Ross, I'll go ahead and tell you. It's been a good day at Ross, guys. But anyways, if I see anything else, I'll show it to you. If I don't, then I'll see you at the next. Here we got, was it one of the animes? I don't know which one. Got four more of these in a lot better shape than the one to have back in the toy section. Whole other stack of these Power Ranger 3-packs. I don't really know how many is in that. Another dinosaur, Batmobile. There was nobody standing here. There was like 15 people on this table. Let's see what else we got. There's Marge. Some Nerf guns, guys, and I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back. Got a Zaymont down here. They've shown back up in force. And then also saw these in Bristol today as well, but they've got three of the Mighty Morphin Pudgy Pig little lunchbox kits. So that's pretty cool. $8.99. All right, that's done it for everything except for what's up at the register. Let's go see what we can find. Awesome finds today, guys, and now my faith is restored in this Ross because look, they've got a siren. There's some Sesame Street stuff. Transformers, Mario, that little snake thingy there from the animated He-Man show, Endeavor. This looks like all of those older legacy figures. Thor. Oh, hang on, Thor. I got you, buddy. I got him. Let's lay him over here. What else we got in here? My Hero statues. Power Ranger stuff. More Zaymont and a Darwin. Power Ranger statue stuff. Alright. So nothing really too exciting up here. That's gonna wrap this Ross up. See anything else I'll show it to you? If not, see you the next one. Home Base Ross. All the others, let me change the trash. All the other ones I've been in today have been hitters with all kinds of cool different stuff. So let's see if the streak continues. I'm starting to feel a little bad for Black Adam there. He's been hanging out here probably longer than about anything. And no one seems to want him. If I didn't already have him, I'd grab him. These are all still the Ahsokas. So we're just in here yesterday, so I already got that footage in the video. Seven Deadly Sins. We're just looking for some different stuff. They got these. Who makes these? They still Jazzwares? Whoever makes the other ones? I don't know. Anyways, I probably have my camera on it. Anybody knows who makes these things, let me know. They got most of the stuff covered there. Man, they had that Hyperius thing. I'd probably grab it. But those are showing up. In that scale, pretty regular. Is this one kind of town? Nope, another sticker. How much are these things? $1.99. Wow. I think Master Chief is all they've got. What else? Anything else different? Minecraft. Got a Static Shock hanging out back there. Marvel Legends still got Quake. There's a Transformer, but it is not Cosmos. And Got speedball steel. Nice little Nerf Dungeons and Dragons thing. That's different. That's kind of cool. How much is that thing? I know somebody probably liked that. $7.99. Madam Hydra, still got her. Same Star Wars figures. I haven't done a pre-scan, guys. I don't know if they got anything different. Oh, there's another Halo. That's not one of the... No, that seems to be the only one they got. Oh, they got that top. What is this thing? I saw everybody posting this today on a lot of the Instagram stuff. So I want to take a picture of it. Apparently, it's cool. It doesn't. Oh, it's a transformer. $25. Oof. Kind of cool, but we'll hang on to that. Oh, what do we got down here? Another one of those things. And then down here, got a tech deck ramp back in there. Cycle man. All right, guys. Let's get over to the tables and see what else we can find. Does not have a platinum, do they? No. Okay, let's get to the tables. Okay, just a quick overview of the tables. Only thing, they got a bunch of Recondos here, a case of him, $5.99. And then just scanning down through here, I don't really see much different. They do have the Dungeons and Dragons figures there. They had all four of those, if you see those. I don't recall if they had those when I was here yesterday. And then it's to show they still have, they still got a bunch of Crockmasters. Yeah, she got four, six Crockmasters, and they got a bunch of Zayamont right there still. So still pretty good representation of GIJoe Classifieds. But that is it for this Ross. If we do find anything else, I'll show it to you. If not, I'll see you at the next one. The home base Walmart. We're going to end the hunt for this video, at least here at the home base. They've been a little disappointing lately. Let's hope they got something good. It's probably get a little bit choppy, guys. I apologize. There's a lot of people in the aisle here, but look at the shipwrecks. Just send them on to Ross. And I got a bunch of what's his name? I went completely blank. Scrap iron is right there, and I still forgot. These were actually cheaper online. I don't know if they still are, but. I also don't know if Walmart price matches their app. I assume they would. Target does. I'm sure Walmart does. These are the ones. I don't know about him. But I know these are showing up at Ross stores for like $3.99. She'll be at Ross stores eventually. In droves. I don't see anything else. Power Ranger or G.I. Joe. It looks cool. Let's see what we got over here. AEW Supreme back in there. CM Punk. I'm not digging him out. Besides, he's sitting down lower on the shelf here and sees me to get to him. There's Mr. Perfect. Got a Yellow Boots Hogan and a Roddy Piper. And these are all unpunched. That's cool. I've already got all three of those, though. Oh, they got Mr. T. This one, like maybe the second or third time I found him. I think it's the third time. I've already got him, too, though. I never have found a Mr. T with a really good card. They're always kind of messed up. This is one I went back and forth on about getting. It's Bam Bam. That one's very cool. Macho Man. Randy Orton's out the wazoo. I saw Brock Lesnar. Where did I see that at? Oh, he's down there on that shelf. Sorry for the quick spin, guys. I forget sometimes. That doesn't come across well on camera. Lando's got a little Ahsoka. What do we got here? Princess Leia, Lando's. I got... Cinderella, Chopper, HK87, Captain Hoo-Ha. So it has some of the new ones here, but just not now. We found that really new wave over the weekend. That was awesome. Here's the WWE's gonna have to get some figures out on him eventually, because right now this is about the only actual Sentinel LJN thing that you can find. I'm sure his two or three fans are wanting figure of him, WWE, now that he has returned. Well, we got Micro Galaxies. Nothing too sad. This right here is what they got to sexy. That's nice. Oh, that is nice. McFarlane we'll get to right here in a second. What's over here? Don't see anything. Let's make our way to the video game aisle. Mario, Lynx. I don't see any Samus. Little X-Men 97. No carded X-Men. I can't get to McFarlane, guys. There's nothing there. Infected Batman. Old stuff. Nothing new. Black Lightning's the only thing they got there I saw that's new. Got the Rose. Still got that's been here for quite a while, actually. Surprised nobody's picked that up yet. A lot of the figures you're starting to see hit Ross. Classic Loki. Nothing really new. You got that old Ragnarok Loki Titan Heroes figure. Genghis Wing Nuts. Genghis's Wing Nuts. They got Leo. Those are the clearance now, I think. Elite. Yep, Leo. $12.50 a piece for Leo and Mikey, down from 20. And then we got their Coronation Starscreams up there. I see Sludge. And then Ratchet. I got two Ratchets there. That's pretty cool. We found him a bunch of times today. He looks like he's starting to hit pretty regular if anybody's been trying to find him. I think that's going to do it, guys, for the main toy aisle. Again, sorry I couldn't show the McFarlane stuff, but it's the same old stuff we always see. But let's go check out collectors. If you see anything, I'll show it to you. If not, we'll see you the next one. Collector section, they still got a bunch of the Turtle 2-packs. I got Kino and the Fat Foot Soldier back there. And the regular Foot Soldiers. I don't see any more of the Turtles. There is one of the Foot Soldiers. What I came in here for, tent stakes. My Christmas decorations keep blowing all over the place, so yeah. Anyways, they got the Ultimate Foot Ninja down there. Very cool to see. Oh, they got Shredder in hell. I don't remember if I saw him here or not. We're going to scan him to see if he might be the 15 bucks. I'd like to find one of those, but I'd like to find it at the 15 bucks. They got those Turtle Black and White packs. Gundam and stuff I don't know anything about. Mortal Kombat figures. That guy right there is hitting Ross for $4.99. So don't pay full price for him. If you can find him at Ross. If you have a Ross. Hopefully you have a Ross. I saw that for $11.99 today at Ross as well. But anywho, what else we got here? SH Figure Art stuff. Got Beth Harmon from the Queen's Gambit. Bunch of Queen's Gambit. Cad Bane's. Oh, they got Bill from Contra. Let's check the little NECA section up here. They still have a ton. Guys, all these art pops down here are $5 each. They show 25 bucks, but I've scanned them before. I've been buying those for the pop covers. I don't need any more, though. There's another Kino and a Fat Ninja and the April Casey Farmhouse 2-pack. Another one of those pop protector things. Let's see if they've got the new... Oh, they do. Right there for video games. That's what the man wants, that Arkham trilogy. I will get that eventually for the Switch. But I think that's going to do it, everybody. If I see anything else in here, I'll let you see it. If I don't, then we're going to see you probably for the wrap-up to this wonderful toy hunting adventure. Welcome back, everyone, to The Man Collects. My name is Chris, and once again, we have had a toy hunting adventure here on The Man Collects. Thank you very much for joining me here and joining for this toy hunt. If you made it this far in the video, make sure to hit that little like button. Let YouTube know that you enjoy the content. But let's get into the stores. Where was The Man Collects in this video? Guys, just like every other toy hunter on YouTube is doing right now, and also every toy hunter off of YouTube, we're still hunting Ross because they keep getting different stuff. You think it would have plateaued by now like Ollie's did, but no, Ross just keeps delivering. So we started out, actually some of these stores we were in more than once in this video, but Ross in Greenville, we hit that one twice so far this week. The one in Bristol, again, twice. We hit the Target in Bristol, the Walmart in Bristol, the Ross in Johnson City, and then the Walmart here in Greenville, Tennessee. Now, Store of the Hunt, I mean, it was a landslide this time to me. There was nothing else was close. The Ross in Bristol, Virginia was Store of the Hunt. The reason being, they had the most restock there I had seen at that store in a while. I got there, guys, at the perfect time. They were setting a lot of that stuff out when I got in there, and then
one of the workers there actually told me, he's like, hey, I know we've got some G.I. Joe classified back there. It's a little pirate guy named Shipwreck. And I was like, really? And she told me about 20, 25 minutes, they'd have it out on the floor. So, you know, I still went to Target and all that stuff and killed that 20, 25 minutes, came back. She brought it out there, and she hooked me up with Shipwreck. That was awesome to get him. They had four of them there, so I didn't get the only one. I only grabbed one of them just to spoil the haul portion. So there were still three there when I left. But again, the Recondo, he was there in force. You had Shipwreck come out there. That Pudgy Pig, I hope it's not puffing the microphone too much there, but the Pudgy Pig box set, I think that might have been a Hasbro exclusive. I'm not really for sure on that. They had it there. I also had that Johnson City, but we saw it first there in Bristol. What else they have there? They had all those NECA figures as well. You had Alf. You had Back to the Future. You had Elvira was there. I mean, all kinds of good stuff there at that Bristol, Virginia Ross. So they were really good in stock today. Really cool to see that stuff there. And again, all that stuff, put it at Store of the Hunt, and the fact that I got there at the perfect time for their restock. And again, we're going to continue to hit Ross stores at the end of this week. It's the final push towards Christmas, so any more big surprises they're going to have, it's going to come this week before the Christmas hits this weekend. Let's get into now. We just kind of talked about the Store of the Hunt. It's time to discuss the man's top three. What was the top three coolest things I saw on this hunt? And just to give you a spoiler alert, yes, I have once again got more than three things in the top three. But number three was at Target. On online and in store, they're having a huge sale. I mean, in my opinion, this is kind of a response by Target to the discount retailers kind of smacking Walmart and Target around right now. They've got stuff marked down, I mean, sometimes lower than it will actually go when they put it on clearance. The biggest thing that stands out to me is Masters of the Universe. The Ram Man and Clawful figures, they got down to under $10 for those. And they're usually over $30 at retail. And they didn't even hit clearance this time. They just put them on sale. And then Snake Mountain is marked down $20. They had 10 of them at the Target in Bristol. I showed you in the video, they're down to one. They sold 9 of those things and they dropped the price $20. But it's not just Motu. You've got marvellegends on sale. That whole way, Hydra Stomper, I forgot, it starts with Hope Buster. The Hydra Stomper wave there with Kingpin, you got Agatha Harkness, Nick Fury, Warrior Gamora, all those are on sale. Most of them are $9.99. I think Agatha's $7.49, and then Warrior Gamora, I think, is the most expensive. I think she's like still like $12.50 or something like that. But still, really good prices marked down to get that wave of figures there if you wanted to get that and complete that Hydra Stomper Build-A-Figure. The DC Multiverse, the Aquaman there, the gold label, $9.99. Supergirl's down to $9.99. A lot of the wrestlers are on sale. So again, if you're looking for stuff, and G.I. Joe Classifieds, they had, it was Ripper, I think. It was one of the Dreadnoughts online. One of them was still full price. One of them was $9.99. He just came out. But G.I. Joe Classifieds, get on Target's website, get on their app. I'm pretty sure that sale is still going on. I was in there today as I'm recording, which is Tuesday the 19th. So check your Target stores, check your Target app, check their website. They got a lot of good collectibles and toys on sale right now. But that takes number three, was the huge sale at Target. Number two is going to be finding more NECA at Ross. And I had a viewer, I can't remember who, put a comment on a previous, maybe one of my shorts where I had the NECA Toonie Terrors, about that being the NECA finally coming to Ross. I did forget some of those Ninja Turtle comic series NECA figures were hitting Ross earlier in the Christmas season. The Renette, whatever her name is. And some people found the Slash figure as well. I forgot about that. So whoever made that comment, thank you. I did forget about that. And I still kind of like to find Slash, to be quite honest. I like that figure. But again, the Toonie Terrors and stuff are hitting in force right now. Between all the Ross stores I was in, we saw a bunch here in the last couple of days. We saw Jason Voorhees, which I didn't pick that up, guys. This is Spoil the Haul again. I came that close, but I don't need to. I need to quit buying multiples of crap just to be able to take it out of the box. But they had the Miner from My Bloody Valentine, Reagan from The Exorcist, they had Marty McFly, Back to the Future, Alf. I did not expect to see that Alf figure. I don't know about your guys' areas with Target, but those Alf figures sold like crazy in my Target. I mean, they hardly stayed on the shelf very long at all whenever they restocked them. So it was surprising to see Alf turn up there. there. But Ash from Army of Darkness and Evil Dead, they had him. Elvira, we saw her. And Elvira, I think, is Svengoolie. And then who's the other one? Vampira, maybe? I can't remember. I'm thinking they're the current wave. It's still in Target stores. So it's kind of surprising to see those hit Ross. Now, the discount on those, in my opinion, is not that great. I mean, if they were around $7.99, I'd probably be a buyer on some of them, but they're $11.99, which is $3 off of retail. But again, guys, it's NECA. How many times do you see sales on NECA? It does hit clearance sometime, but it's not all the time you see discounted NECA figures. So it's cool to see those at Ross, and that's why they're number two. Okay, number one. What took the top spot this week? And I did kind of go back and forth on a couple of different things, but I settled on G.I. Joe Classifieds because you had Recondo, which I knew was hitting. I had no idea Shipwreck was hitting Ross stores. And out of the stuff that I follow and look at, the man Collects was the first person I saw to find Shipwreck, and then he started popping up all over Instagram. People were finding him. I haven't checked YouTube, and I'm sure people beat me. I'm not saying I'm the first one that found it at Ross. I'm sure there's 80,000 people out there on YouTube and Instagram that beat me to it. But I'm the first person I realized that saw it, so I didn't realize they would get that figure, which is pretty cool. And I've heard they're getting some more, but, you know, we saw Recondo, we found Shipwreck, a huge restock on Crocmaster. Bristol was wiped out. Greenville still had some of theirs you saw in the second part of the Greenville hunt there. And then the Twins have come back around. Used to be you only sold Tomax. Now you're seeing Zaymont come back around. So, you know, they're getting both sets of Twins now in there, which is cool to see. We saw some Sentinels at Ross, but we're not seeing a big restock on the Marvel stuff, but we did see a restock and some new G.I. Joes, and there's supposed to be some more coming down the line here from Ross, you know, Copperhead and some more. So G.I. Joe Classified gets number one spot for this hunt. All right, guys, there we go. Let's get into our toy hunt. And again, we do have another sizable hunt, but again, it's a big Ross haul, so it didn't cost all that much money, which is awesome. We're going to show the big ticket item first that I got. I did make an order from Big Bad Toy Store. There was one of the Avengers 60th figures I did not get that I wanted because I thought it was too expensive. Well, Big Bad Toy Store had it on sale for $40, and it is the Super Adaptoid. This thing looks great. I mean, it's a hodgepodge of all the Avengers there with some of the different weapons, Thor's hammer and Captain America's shield. And you'll probably notice this box, I'm slinging it around, is not making any noise. That's because we already opened the figure. This thing is great. I mean, I wanted to get this out to pose it on the shelf. The only problem I'm having, guys, if anybody's got this, let me know. How do you get the freaking shield to stay on his arm? Because this fin here on his gauntlet, I cannot get the shield straps to go over that. And I'm afraid I'm going to break them. Now, I can take his fist off and get it through, you know, the little small hole in the front, but I can't get his hand or the back strap of the shield to get on there, so the shield will stay on there, right? So we're still trying to figure that out. But again, awesome figure. Glad to get it at a discounted price. All right, next we'll talk about Target there in Bristol. We did have a pickup from that Target store, and I've been eyeballing this thing forever. Kingpin, he was $9.99. He was showing $12.49 on the shelf, but I showed the girl to register the app where it was $9.99, and she said, I mean, of course we're going to price match our own price. So she went ahead and overrid that, and I got this for $9.99, plus with another 5% off because I had a Target card. So we finally got our discounted D'Onofrio Kingpin. And yeah, he may hit $7.99, guys. He may when he goes on clearance, but these things have been selling very well in my area. There's only one Target store that has a big stock of these things, and you guys know as soon as they hit that clearance, they're gone. They're going to disappear. With this sale going on, they're probably also going to disappear, so he went ahead and got the Kingpin while he was only $10. Alright, the rest of this is all Ross items, so I can't remember really what stores I got them from, so let's just go through the thing. The first thing we picked up, we did get Geralt here from The Witcher 3 Wild Hunt, a $4.99 for a Witcher figure. Of course, I'm going to pick that up. This is coming out of the box. I'll find something to do with Geralt, but again, I had to pick him up there. He looked too cool for $5 to pass up. Our next pickup was Punk Rock Superman, and I was not going to get this. This did come from Johnson City, Ross. I remember that, because the one I found in the video that I carried around, the hanger or the thing here was messed up big time. Well, this one was not. This one's in perfect shape in the box. Now, the Dark Father is one build-a-figure, and you can see a picture of him there on the back that I would like to put together. So if I could find the rest of this wave, if the rest of this wave hits Ross for $5.99, I will get it. We will build Dark Father. But, you know, I usually keep these in box, so if we don't find them, we've got a nice box to keep, you know, Punk Rock Superman in. Alright, let me find a place to put him. I got too much stuff here on my desk. You can't see the mess here, guys. I gotta clean this up. But our next Ross pickup, and this is an impulse buy that I probably shouldn't have got, but it was only $10. We did pick up this Halo Mantis thing. And with one of the other pickups here, I've got an idea how I'm going to pose them on the shelf with this thing kind of fighting something here I've got on my desk. And no, it's not super adaptoid, although that might not be a bad idea. But, you know, we're going to use this thing to put on the shelf and mess around with. All right, our next Ross pickups were the number one item you heard me talk about there in the top three. But we did pick up Rakondo, who's going to come out of the box. And again, go over there on the shelf if you can't see behind me over here with some G.I. Joes on it that I do take out of the box. And then because that that Ross employee was so nice to help me get one of these, I had to pick up a shipwreck. So we got us another shipwreck. Again, one of my favorite Joes. I've still got my original shipwreck. This one's also coming out of the box to go on the shelf. I've got one of these to keep in box now. I got it retail, and now I got this one to take out of the box and mess around with. Now, my next pickup was also an impulse buy, but I have a family member, I'm pretty sure, that is a Power Rangers fan. So I got this for a possible Christmas present. I find out they might be something they're interested in. But I picked up the Pudgy Pig. I think this was a Hasbro Pulse exclusive. It was $9 at Ross there, so we did pick that up. The presentation in this box thing is awesome. I know someone who's a fan told me this is the same figure that was out that is put in this dress of your box, but we did get Pudgy Pig. And then the last pickup, guys, of this, another enormous, you know, Ross haul. We did get, if I can get him around here, not drop him, we got the Ice Giant from The Witcher. I eyeballed this thing forever. I think in the video I said $18. He never got below, I think, $25, $26 at GameStop. That was a slip of the tongue. But again, I always wanted to pick this up, but the clearance price never got to where I wanted it. And even if it had it back then, it wouldn't have been $5.99. I mean, $5.99 for this, guys? I mean, how can any... I mean, I couldn't leave it on the shelf for that price. I don't know if anybody else could. But again, I could not. Obviously, I bought it. So we're going to get him. We're going to open him up. And we're going to mess around with him with some poses and things like that. All right. That is it, guys. That is the hunt. That is the top three. That is the toy haul. So let's talk about social media. Where can you find the man collects in the wonderful world of social media? Instagram. Description of this video. About page on YouTube, you will find the link to get to my Instagram. You'll also see the link flashing here on the screen. Now, you can't click on it here on the screen, but you can type that in, and it'll take you to my page on Instagram. Consider giving me a follow. Been growing pretty good on Instagram, trying to get more content out on Instagram as well to help grow it there. But check me out there and give me a follow if you'd like to. And then we have the YouTube channel, The Man Collects. I set a little personal goal here before the end of the year, and I still got, 10, 12 days to get about, I think I need about 15 more subscribers. I like to hit 1,500 subscribers by the end of 2023. Now, if I don't get it, I'm not going to consider it a loss because I just came up with this idea like 2 days ago. But if I can get there, I'd appreciate it. But I can't do it without you. So if you are a first-time viewer to my content, you've come back a few times, you still haven't clicked subscribe, consider clicking subscribe to The Man Collects and see what comes down the pipe on the YouTube channel. All that being said, everyone, this is the Wednesday before Christmas. I'll have one more video out before Christmas, but I hope you're having a good week, and I'll see you back here on Friday.